Good morning, my dear students. Welcome for today's video lecture of maths. Today we are going to start to solve practice 3.6. It is in this practice we are going to solve the word problems based on subtraction. Subtraction stories, we can say. Subtraction stories, that is word problems based on subtraction. So see the first word problem. A trade fair had 23,414 visitors in the first year and 64,879 in the second year. How many more people visited the trade fair in the second year? So see in this problem, what is there? So in the first year, there were 23,414 visitors visited that trade fair, okay, and in the second year 64,879 people visited the trade fair. So as if you see here, in the first year and the visitor visited the trade fair in the first year and second year, you will come to know that here there is 23,000, here there is 64,000. So in the second year more people visited to the trade fair, right? We have to find how many more people visited in the second year than the first year. So in this situation, which operation we have to do to find more, how many more people visited in the second year compared to the first year? What we have to do? We have to do the subtraction, okay? For example, I'll give you another example. See, suppose Ram has 9 mangoes and Shyam has 3 mangoes. Okay, we'll take 5 mangoes. Ram has 9 mangoes, Shyam has 3 mangoes, correct? Who has more mangoes? Ram. Fine. How many more mangoes Ram has than the Shyam? It is same like this, okay? Ram has more mangoes, that is confirmed, we know that. But how many more mangoes Ram has? How many more mangoes Ram has compared to the Shyam or than the Shyam? To find this, now these numbers are smaller, so we can tell easily that Ram has 4 more mangoes. But to find that 4, what we have to do with this? 9 plus 5 you will do, or 9 minus 5? 9 minus 5, when we will do 9 minus 5, then we will get 4. That means Ram has 4 more mangoes than the Shyam. Same it is here. How many more people visited to the trade fair in the second year than the first year? And to find that more people, we have to subtract people visited in the first year from people visited in the second year. Okay, so let's do it. As people visited in the second year are more, so we'll write it up. People visited in, directly I'm writing second year. In second year, how many people visited? 64,879. And in the first year, see, 4, start to write from back side, okay, 3 and 2, that is 23,414. So in the second year, how many more people visited? More people visited in the second year than the first year. That we have to find. And to find how many more people visited in the second year, we have to subtract this from the people visited from the second year, in the second year. Okay, so let's subtract. 9 minus 4 is 5, correct? You have 10 fingers total, so you can take 9 fingers and subtract 4. How many remain? 5. So 9 minus 4 is 5. 7 minus 1, 6. Try to do the calculation in your mind. 8 minus 4, 4, correct? 4 minus 3. 4 minus 3 is 1, okay? 6 minus 2. 6 minus 2 is 4. Understood? So see, 41,465 more people visited in the second year than the first year. So write here 41,465 more people visited in the second year than the first year. Understood? Let's solve the second problem in this practice. A garrison had 1,28,844 soldiers. Out of these, 1,05,312 soldiers were ordered to go to the border. How many soldiers are left in the garrison now? What is this garrison means? Garrisons means where soldiers are living in our country or where in the particular state, and whenever there is a situation of war on the border, those soldiers are ordered to go on the border, right? So there were how many soldiers first? 1,28,844, and out of these soldiers, some soldiers, how many? 1,05,300 soldiers were ordered to go on the border. Means they went to the border. Then how many soldiers left in the garrison? How many soldiers left? How many soldiers left in that garrison? Okay, that we have to find. So to find that remaining soldiers, which operation we have to do? Obviously subtraction. Okay, so total soldiers in garrison. There were 1,28,844 and went on border. Soldiers went on border. How many soldiers went on border? 1,05,312. Correct? So soldiers left in the garrison we have to find. Soldiers left in garrison. Left means remain. So to find this remaining soldiers, number of remaining soldiers in the garrison, we have to subtract. Okay? So 4 minus 2, 2. 4 minus 1, 3. 8 minus 3? 8 minus 3 is 5, correct? 8 minus 3 is 5. Again, 8 minus 5, 3. 2 minus 0, 2. And 1 minus 1, 0. So there, how many soldiers left in that garrison? 23,532. So 23,532 soldiers left in the garrison. Understood? So pause this video and write these both word problems in your notebook. After this, we will solve two more problems. Okay? Let's solve the next problem. Problem number 3. Till last year, a car had traveled 25,874 kilometer. Now its odometer reads 42,958 kilometer. How many kilometers did the car travel in the past 1 year? Means last 1 year. Okay. So see, till last year, car had traveled 25,874 kilometer. Means till last year, its running was 25,874 kilometer. That was the running which was showing in the odometer. If you have seen the odometer in the car which shows the reading of running. Okay, so see, till last year it was 25,874 kilometer. This year means now at the current, it is showing that odometer is showing how much running? 42,958 kilometer. This reading was or running was showing that odometer in the car. So it is increased, right? How many kilometers did the car travel in the past 1 year? Means from this to this. This was the last year's running, and this was the current running. So in this past 1 year, how many kilometers that car had traveled? Okay, that we have to find. That means what? We have to subtract last the running of 1 year before from the current running. Okay, so see here, current means today's, or we can say current running. Today's we will not say. Current, it's current means what? Right, current. So see here, current running of the car. What is what that odometer is showing now? Currently means now. 42,958 kilometer. Okay. If then last year's reading or last year's running was 25,874, that is, okay. So that means till last year that car had traveled 25,874 kilometer, and after now 1 year means now it's running is showing 42,958, means from 25,000 till 42,000, how much increased, that we have to find. So car travel in 1 year, past 1 year means previous year, last 1 year. Okay, so to find that, we need to subtract last year's running from current running. 8 minus 4 is 4. 5 minus 7, not possible, correct? 5 is smaller than 7. So this not possible. So from 9, 1 will take borrow. 5 will be cut, written up. 5 will become 15. 9 will remain 8. 15 minus 7 is nothing but 8. 8 minus 8, 0. 2 minus 5, not possible. So 2 will become 12. 4 will remain 3. 12 minus 5. 7, and 3 minus 2, 1. So from last year till today, car had traveled 17,084 kilometer. Okay, so the car traveled 17,084 kilometer in the past 1 year. In the past 1 year, okay, this much kilometer it has traveled. Understood? Let's move towards the next question. Question number 4. In an election, in an election, 83,657 valid votes were casted. 52,248 votes were in the favor of winning candidate. How many votes did losing candidate get? Now see here, you know, in election when there are two candidates, obviously one candidate wins the election, another candidate lose the election. So in that per election, this much total 83,657 valid votes were casted, means votes were given, okay. So out of means these are total votes, these are total votes. How many? 83,657. Out of these total votes, the candidate who won the election, he got 52,248 votes, okay? Winning candidate. Winning candidate received how many? So that means what? Remaining votes were received to the losing candidates. So how many votes losing candidates got, that we have to find, correct? So losing candidate, how many votes did losing candidate get? To find that, we need to subtract votes got to the winning candidate from the votes, total votes, okay? Total votes. So 7 minus 8. Not possible. So from 5, 1 will take borrow here, 7 will cut, will be written up. 5 will remain 4. Now 17 minus 8 is 17 minus 8. After 8, count till 17. You will get 9. 4 minus 4, 0. 6 minus 2 is 4. 3 minus 2, 1. And 8 minus 5 is 3. Okay. So losing candidate got 31,409 votes. Okay. So this way we have to solve the problems of subtraction. We have to read them carefully. We have to understand what is the situation and accordingly we have to act. Okay. So write this in your notebook and remaining problems we will solve in the next lecture. So thank you for today and have a nice day.